We're talking about Donald Trump dropping out of the race. Would he drop out of the race since he's now slipping in the polls? I'd like to bring in my political expert, Southside Johnny Lyon, on this.
Don't get me started.
Are you going to sell? Why don't you sell Trump a song?
I don't want him singing my songs. I mean, you know,
nobody wants him singing their songs.
You know, who knows who he'd hire to sing the songs? It would be the classiest, most bestest person, but it would be somebody I didn't like, I'm pretty sure.
Right. So far, Tyler said, don't use Dream On. Yeah. And Stipe said, don't use End of the World as We Know It.
Right.
See,
which,
I'm thinking,
which is an interesting campaign song. It's the end of the world as we know it, and I feel fine. Yeah, you got billions of dollars. No kidding.
I'm thinking you should sell Christie, I Don't Want to Go Home, because he's never here.
Well, and unfortunately, I mean, I know Chris Christie a little bit. I like him. I don't like a lot of his policies, but he has blown a lot of credibility in New Jersey, unfortunately. This is a bad political move for him, so we'll see what happens after that.
If Trump were to drop out, he would probably pick up a lot of the residual Trump, because Trump is basically out Christie-ing Christie. You don't think so?
No, not a chance. First of all, as a person who has had to fight for being from New Jersey for the last 40 years, we are not beloved around the country. New Jersey is not the state that everybody goes, ooh, I can't wait to move there, you know? So, no, I don't think he would. I don't know who they're going to end up with, to tell you the truth. It's going to be an interesting thing. It probably is going to be Jeb Bush.
not another one.
Well, the Republican caucuses can get overrid by the RNC, right, and they can actually pick the candidate if they don't like who the caucuses are picking. So
that's a scary thought also.
Well, you know, it's the establishment. That's the way it goes.
Well, Johnny, we got Suzanne in Millstone on New Jersey 101.5. Suzanne, say hello to Southside Johnny.
Hi, Southside Johnny.
How you doing, baby?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I just had a hamburger and a couple of glasses of wine, so I'm okay.
I had a hamburger, too, but no wine.
Well, we'll send you some over.
Would you like some? We can make that happen.
That sounds wonderful.
Suzanne, what do you think is going to happen?
I think Donald Trump will stay in the race. I'd like to see him for president and Carson for vice president.
Why?
Because I really do feel that the country is going down the tubes. I think the whole immigration thing is a mess.
Hold on. The country is a lot better off than it was, say, 10 years ago, 8 years ago. The immigration thing isn't affecting you particularly, right? And
yes, it does affect me.
How does it affect you? In what way?
Because I feel that many of the people that immigrate here are now infringing on my rights. If I choose to say Merry Christmas Christian holidays.
No, almost all of the Latinos and Latinas that are coming up from Latin countries, Mexico and South, are Catholics or Christians, and they all say Merry Christmas. You have to understand.
I didn't signal out Latinos. I said immigrants because...
Oh, you mean the Koreans?
If I went to China, they're not going to give up Buddha and all that for my Christian beliefs.
No, because they're communists, so the Buddhists are not really welcome there. But
the point is, this is America. It was founded on Christianity.
No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't.
Any nationality or religion that chooses to practice here, but... don't take my belief away because you come here and believe something different. I don't like it.
How in the world is anybody taking your Christianity away? Most of the...
But I can't even have a nativity scene out or a display at Christmas. That's infringing on my rights.
Why can't you have a nativity scene?
Because many of these towns, they won't allow it anymore. It's not politically correct.
I have never heard of... you have Suzanne. To provide... chapter and verse as to what town has ever said an individual, private individual, can't have a nativity scene. Come on, you know that's not true.
I'm talking about a private individual. I'm talking about a display in front of a church or in a town.
No, the church, no, Suzanne, the church can do whatever they want.
You mean the town center.
The town center, that's
different. And I'll tell you something right now. I live in a town that is a Methodist town. we have every year, Santa comes, they've got the whole nativity scene right in Fireman's Park. Everybody comes down there. There are a lot of gay people that come down. Everybody participates. I'm sure there's some Muslim people. Who knows if there's a Buddhist or not? And nobody ever interferes with that. You're thinking about the things that happen to, because some idiot says they can't have a nativity. I'm not against the town having a nativity. Nobody really is. It's just a couple of people. And it certainly isn't the immigrants that are doing that.
All right, Suzanne, thanks for the call to New Jersey 101.5. Look at you, Southside Johnny. Well, issues I and mean, answers.
Well,
face the nation. Face Southside Johnny, face New Jersey. This
well,
is good.
You know, unfortunately, there's a lot of rhetoric, and Donald Trump is a
proponent thereof.
Well, not all of it, no. I mean, what I like is he is forcing the Republicans' feet to the fire till they have to answer some questions. But, you know, there is a lot of rhetoric that goes on. And unfortunately, with the internet and the mass communications that we have, every small, tiny incident that happens in somewhere hundreds of miles away is something that's immediate on your computer and you think it's happening to you. And it really isn't. I mean, Christianity is not really under attack in America. Anybody who really thinks that's true is just... You ought to unplug the computer and go out and walk around and talk to your neighbors.
Imagine if, see, you can do that where you live. I know where you live. I used to own a coffee shop where you live.
Oh, yeah.
How's that doing now? Is that still in business?
Which one?
The Bavarian Bean?
Yes. Somebody else has bought it. We had a big fire there, and a lot of it got burned out.
I had nothing to do with that. This was long after I got rid of it.
I'm sure that you had nothing to do with it.
I'm going to be back with Southside Johnny. 1-800-283-101.5. I got...